What is in the blood of Jesus? Number one, it is the nature of Christ. Number one, it is the nature of Christ. Leviticus chapter number 17. Leviticus chapter number 17 and verse number 11. The blood is the life carrier. You should know that. The Bible says, for the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it upon you on the altar to make an atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul. For the life of the flesh is in the blood. Uhai wa kila kiumbe umo katika damu. Uhai wa kila kiumbe umo katika damu. Tunapochukua damu ya Yesu, tunachukua uzima wa Kristo. Tunachukua uhai, tunachukua uzima. Just imagine getting the life of God in your life. On top of that life you have, you get another divine life of Jesus. You become super kangara. You become super kangara. You can never be conger. Kwa hivyo, damu ya Yesu, damu inabeba the nature. Hali halisi ya Kristo, imo katika damu. Hali halisi, imo katika damu. That's why we normally say there is power in the blood of Jesus. There is life in the blood of Jesus. The life content in the blood is working over your life. The life content in the blood of Jesus is working over your life in the name of Jesus. Number two, what is in the blood? I'm calling sanctification power. There is sanctification power in the blood of Jesus. Sikiza nikuambie. Hebu jaribu siku moja. Chukua maji ya karai na uchukua ile sabuni unajua kuoga vizuri na inatoa uchafu kabisa. Chukua na uoge. Tangia saa 12 asubuhi mpaka jioni. Jisugue kabisa. Na unielezee bali jioni kama utakuwa umeondoa dhambi. Chukua maji na sabuni. Sugua kutoka asubuhi. Nataka nikuhakikishie utabaki kuwa mchafu vile vile kama ulikuwa na dhambi, utabaki kuwa na dhambi zako kutoka asubuhi mpaka jioni na pengine utajiumiza. Lakini damu ya Yesu inatakasa. Damu ya Yesu yatakasa. We have sanctification power. Yatakasa. Nguvu za utakaso. Atupokee utakaso kutokana na waganga. Damu za kuku na hizo vitu. Tunapokea kwa damu ya Yesu. Na ni damu ya Yesu pekee inaweza nena utakaso juu ya maisha yetu. Inaweza takasa. Check in the book of John 17:17. The Bible says, sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth. Watakase kwa ile kweli. Maana neno lako ni kweli. Neno la Mungu lina uhai. Latakasa. Neno la Mungu li hai. Linatakasa. Now, whenever we take the blood of Jesus, yatakasa. Inatakasa. Inatakasa. Yatakasa. Yatakasa. The blood sanctifies. The blood sanctifies. Damu yatakasa. I plead the mercy and the blood of Jesus over your life. I plead the mercy and the blood of Jesus over your life. Damu ya Yesu itakase. Remember, self-justification can never take you anywhere. You need the blood of Jesus. You need the power of God. Self-justification can never take you to heaven. It can never take you anywhere. You need the blood of Jesus. You need the blood of Jesus. Number three thing. What is in the blood? It is an activator of blessing. The blood is an activator of blessing. The blood is an activator of blessing. In the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter number 10, verse number 16. 1 Corinthians 10, verse number 16. The Bible says, the cup of blessing which you bless, is it not the communion of the blood of Christ? And the bread which you break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ? Holy communion, and more preciously, the blood of Jesus is an activator of blessing. Once you partake it, you are activating your blessing. You are activating your blessing. You are activating your blessing. Number four, it is the seal of our redemption. Remember, Jesus said, do it as much as you do to remember me. Take it as often. To remember me. It is our seal of redemption. Damu tuliokolewa na damu yenye dhamana. Tuliokolewa. Now, Matthew 20, 28, Matthew 20, 28, the Bible says, even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and to give his life a ransom to many, a ransom for many. He came to give his life a ransom for many. He gave his life a ransom for many. He gave his life a ransom for many. Damu ya Yesu, ndiyo siri, ama ndiyo siri ya wokovu wetu. Tumeokolewa kwa damu. Ndiyo maana, hata katika madhabahu za wachawi na washirikina, zinawekwa damu, damu za kondoo, damu za kuku. Hizo damu hazizungumzi na wala hazina uweza. Damu ya Yesu inaweza, inanena mema. Hii damu itaokoa, hii damu inaponya, hii damu inatenda makubwa, hii damu inafanya makubwa zaidi. Hii damu ina uweza na nguvu. Damu ya Yesu ina uhai. Damu ya Yesu inafunja nira. Damu ya Yesu inafunja kila baria. Inafunja kila vikwazo. You need the power in this blood. You need the power in the blood of Jesus to destroy every bondage, to destroy every curse, to paralyze every curse in the name of Jesus. You need the power in the blood of Jesus. Unahitaji nguvu za damu ya Yesu ili ukaweze kushinda. Unahitaji damu ya Yesu. That is why, time to time, even when we are praying for people, we seek the blood of Jesus. We declare, we invoke the power in the blood of Jesus. Damu ina nguvu zaidi. Imepita nguvu za wanadamu. Imepita nguvu za damu ya kuku na ngombe na mbuzi. Imepita damu za wanyama. Hiyo damu inaweza. Hiyo damu inafanya kazi katika maisha yako. It is working from today over your life. It speaks deliverance. It speaks safety. It speaks protection and salvation. It is our seal of redemption. May the Lord fight your battles. May the Lord fight your battles. Now, damu ya Yesu inapigana na kila silaha zote ambazo adui anatumia, ambazo anatumia kufikia maisha yako, iwe ya magonjwa, iwe ya maradhi, iwe ya ushirikina. Damu ya Yesu inapigana nayo, ina neutralize kila poison. Wengine wamekulisha vitu mbalimbali katika ndoto, umelishwa katika ndoto, umelishwa uchawi. Nataka nitangaze kwa damu ya Yesu, hiyo kitu inaenda kupigwa kwa damu ya Yesu. That infirmity will be unhealthed and be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. The blood will work miraculously in the name of Jesus. So wherever you are, I want us to call the power in the blood of Jesus right now. Every sickness must bow. Let me tell you, there is no barrier that is bigger than the blood of Jesus. I mean, that can be bigger to confront, to comprehend this power in the blood of Jesus. There is no limitation that can comprehend the blood of Jesus. There is no force, there is no any power that can comprehend this power, the power in the blood of Jesus. Wherever you are, maybe you are sick, I want to declare there is healing power in the name of Jesus. I want to declare healing, healing in the name of Jesus. Maybe you are under curse. I want us to call the blood of Jesus right now. The blood that has life, and that curse must broke. That curse must bow. In the name of Jesus, that curse must be destroyed. In the name of Jesus, that limitation, that rejection must loose. And your life must be free in the name of Jesus. Maybe you are under a sequential rejection style in life. Umekataliwa kila mara. Unaenda huku unakataliwa, unaenda kule unakataliwa. Pesa imekukataa, maisha imekukataa, umevunjika, you are disappointed, you are discouraged. You need the power in the blood of Jesus. You need this power. When we invoke the power of the blood of Jesus, miraculous must be evident. You will see how God will do it over your life. Utaona vile Mungu anafanya. Kuna nguvu katika damu ya Yesu. Wakati damu ya Yesu litiririka, Biblia inasema baada ya kuwa pale msalabani akasema yameisha. Nataka nitangaze kila mateso
ambayo yapo katika maisha yako yanaisha kwa jina la Yesu. Hiyo kufinyiliwa inaisha, hiyo kuonewa inaisha, hayo masimango yanaisha, hiyo kudharauliwa na kudhiakiwa inaisha kwa damu ya Yesu. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I want to declare it is over in the name of Jesus. You can never be reproached anymore. I want to declare an end of that reproach, an end of that disappointment, an end of that discouragement. And I want to speak a new beginning by the power in the blood of Jesus. By the power in the blood of Jesus, so wherever you are, I want us to pray by the power in the blood of Jesus. We want to call to invoke the power of God, to invoke the power of the blood of Jesus, to itisha nguvu ndani ya damu ya Yesu, mambo yabadilike. Maybe you are jobless. There is job in the blood of Jesus. So wherever you are, just commit yourself to this platform. Let us pray all together. Let us ask the power in the blood of Jesus to manifest. Let us ask the power in the blood of Jesus. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you this day. We thank you for your faithfulness. Daddy, thank you for your might. Daddy, thank you for that listener. Thank you for that viewer. Thank you for their life. Thank you for the condition they are passing through. I speak the power of God. In that condition, I speak the power of God. I speak the blood of Jesus. I destroy that infirmity. I cast that infirmity in their bodies. That sickness is hereby rebuked. I cast that infirmity in the name of Jesus. I cast that joblessness in the mighty name of Jesus. I cast that curse in the name of Jesus. Whatever bondage of the enemy, I cast it right now. Malaba lababu seteli mayanda laba. Malobo seteli mayomu lobo sahanda. Makashata yanda laba laba. I speak the power of God. I speak the grace of God right now. By the blood of Jesus, let whatever evil plantation in their bodies, may it be uprooted right now. By the blood of Jesus, may it be uprooted right now. By the power of God, I cast that infirmity. I cast that infirmity in their bodies, in their lives. That curse is hereby destroyed. I speak the power of God. I speak the grace of God. That rejection is hereby terminated. That force is hereby commanded to bow. That force is hereby terminated. I destroy them forever. I charge their lives with the blood of Jesus. I soak their destinies in the blood of Jesus. The power of God, the blood of Jesus over their lives. In the name of Jesus, Daddy, thank you. To the jobless, I speak new jobs. To those who are sick, I speak healing power. Healing power. Healing power in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Daddy, because you're faithful. Thank you, precious Lord. Thank you, Redeemer Father. Thank you, precious Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. So, viewer, wherever you are, I want you to understand, as much as you practice, as you engage in practicing the covenant, it will keep your life in the right direction. Keep committing and keeping the covenant, it will work for you. And at this juncture, I want us to partake of the communion table. I want us to partake it. I want us to take it right now in the name of Jesus. I want us, viewers, wherever you are, it is the time to engage in keeping the covenant. I want to read in the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter number 11, verse 23, downwards. 1 Corinthians, chapter number 11, verse 23. The Bible says, "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, soever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord, unworthily shall be guilty of the body
and the blood of the Lord. Now, before you partake of this, it is good for you to understand this. We are keeping the covenant. The only dimension the Bible gives us, it is for you to be a covenant child. You must be born again for you to receive this one. Remember at the beginning we said we are not doing it as another tradition. We are doing it wholly and purely. We are keeping in line with the word. And the only prescription, you must be born again. Wherever you are, make sure you are born again. This, it will work miraculously. So, I request you, wherever you are, please take some juice, take some either biscuits or bread. I will bless it to be holy. I will bless it to be holy. And you will take it. You will draw a lot of power. You will draw a lot of strength. You will be empowered. Triumphs will come over your life. Make sure you partake it all together. So please, you can arrange, get your stuffs, get your cup of drink and something to take it off. That is like biscuit and bread. And you are praying for it. This is the only way that the Bible prescribes to us that we should be born again. You should be born again. And maybe you are there. You want to partake it and you are not born again. Please pray after me. Say, Lord Jesus, this day I come before you. I pray, Lord, that you may forgive my sins. I open my heart for you, dear Lord, that you may get in to be Lord and Savior in my life. Write my name in the book of life and erase it in the book of death. From today, I receive you, Jesus Christ, as the Lord and Savior in my life. Be my Lord always. Be my guider and be my leader. I will follow your instructions and your commands. From today, I believe in my spirit and my mind that I'm a covenant child, and by receiving you, Christ, in my life, I'm born again. I'm sanctified and I'm forgiven. Thank you, Jehovah God, for forgiving my sins. Thank you for accepting me. Thank you for blessing. Thank you for blessing my life. In Jesus' mighty name, you are now being born again. Now I want us to pray for this communion table so that we can finish our service in the name of Jesus. I want us to pray for even what you're holding. Maybe it is a biscuit, maybe it is a cup of juice, but make sure it is not wine. I'm not praying for wine, please. Here it is not wine. It should be either a drink, whichever kind of a drink, but not wine, not alcoholic. A drink and either biscuit or bread. Let us pray for it. Father, thank you for the bread that my viewer is holding in the hands. Thank you for the enlarged. Daddy, I bless the bread to be the body of Christ. I bless it to be holy for the purposes of communion table. I bless the cup they are holding. I bless that juice to become the blood of Jesus, the blood of the new covenant. By the blood of Jesus, Father, I sanctify them to be holy communion table. As she partake of it, may your power flow all over. May we draw endless triumphs. May we draw power in our bodies and in our spirit. I bless them, Lord. As you partake it, we are taking the body and the blood of Jesus for endless triumphs. We are partaking the body and the blood of Jesus for endless triumphs. We are receiving sanctification power. We are receiving supernatural power. In the name of Jesus, I declare it is filled and it is already sanctified. In Jesus' precious name. Please, wherever you are, you can take it together with me. Maybe you are sick. Either sick man or even wherever you are, let us believe God that infirmity must be uprooted by the blood of Jesus. Remember, I've told you it is the rod that swallows the rods of the magicians.
Let us pray. Lift your voice. Begin to cast any evil in the family in your life. Begin to cast it in the name of Jesus. Kila roho ya kuonewa. Ninaifunja kwa jina la Yesu. Nafunja kila madhabahu inayofanya kazi kinyume na huyu mpendwa. Nafunja katika jina la Yesu. Chochote ambacho kinafinyilia maisha ya mtazamaji. Ninaifunja katika jina la Yesu. Kila pando za wachawi na washirikina ninazingua zote. Be uprooted in the name of Jesus. I cut it out right now by the power of God, by the blood of Jesus. Makashata yanda la balaba. Ninafunja hiyo madhabahu. Ninafunja hiyo ngome. Ninafunja hiyo kukataliwa. Nafunja that barrier. I break it in the name of Jesus. I speak it in power. Be healed. Be free right now. Be healed in the name of Jesus. I invoke the power in the communion table, the power in the body and the blood of Jesus over their lives. I declare the power of God. Be free, be free, be delivered, be free, be set free in the name of Jesus. I bless their life and I bless their destinies. Thank you, Redeemer Father. Thank you for your deliverance power. Thank you for your healing power. Thank you, Daddy, for your power. Thank you for your mighty. Father, we love and we worship you. In Jesus' precious name. And somebody say amen. So wherever you are, the power is all over you now. And the strength of God is all over you now. You are receiving supernatural power and the strength over your life. It is no longer the same again. To the jobless, go and receive a job. The favor is all over you now. To those who are sick, receive healing power. Within yourself, there is healing power. And then the environment you are in, power of healing is over there. You are going to be free in the name of Jesus. To those who are under bondage, you are delivered. You are delivered. You are delivered in the name of Jesus. So thank you for taking your time, even to this far, for watching and following. Please, it is good, as I taught you, it is good to keep covenant. Covenant keeping, it is what makes us to be sustained in the grace of God. I want us to give to the Lord. It's good to give to the Lord. The Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 8, verse number 18, Deuteronomy 8, 18, you shall remember the Lord your God who gives you power to produce wealth. You shall remember the Lord your God. He is the one who gives you power to make that wealth. It is not about you. It is about God who has given you power to producing wealth. So package your offering, your tithe, your first fruit, your prophet offering. Package it so that you may honor the Lord of Lords with our substances. Please, you can even channel your offering, your tithe to this number. 0717-991-326. I repeat, 0717-991-326. Make sure you get connected to this grace. The Lord Jesus will bless you mightily and abundantly in the name of Jesus. So it is good we give to the Lord. Let us commit our services to our offerings to the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for our offerings and our tithes. We thank you even because of the viewer. Thank you for their offerings, their tithes, and their first fruits. I declare your blessing upon their lives. I declare increment in the name of Jesus. Father, increase them. Father, expand them. Let there be multiplication upon their lives. I rebuke the devil on their behalf. I say thank you for you want to show yourself. Thank you, precious Lord, because there is none like you. I accept our offerings, and as you accept them, Father, increase and bless us in return. Thank you, precious Lord. In Jesus' precious name we do pray, and somebody shout amen. Now, as we finish our service, I want you to, just by the mercies of God, to request, make sure that you subscribe, make sure that you share to your friends and to your relatives, make people as much as possible to be connected so that you may flow by this grace in the name of Jesus. I declare you are favored. You are blessed. This week, you will make it. You shall be blessed. This month of April, doors will open on your behalf. Increment will answer unto your life. That barrenness is hereby terminated. That sickness is hereby put off
In the name of Jesus, I declare by the grace of God upon my life, if I be a man of God, COVID-19 shall never come near your life. It shall never come near your family. It shall never come near your loved ones. You will never die. I speak to the Lord of your life. In Jesus' precious name. Be blessed. Be blessed forever. In Jesus' precious name.